Hi folks, 18 by 12 piece of 3mm MDF. It's got a coat of gesso, dried with a hairdryer, then some artist quality titanium white mixed with a bit of PVA glue and then dried again. I sanded in between to give it fairly smooth. A bit shiny there, but that doesn't matter. I want to do something with a bit of a pond flood in, which would be rather topical the way things are in the UK at the moment with the floods everywhere. So that's in my head. So let's just mix some paint. The palette is Payne's grey, sap green, red ochre, ultramarine, bit of red if I want it, cadmium red, white of course, and some yellow ochre. But the basic palette is yellow ochre, cadmium red, red ochre and the Payne's grey. So I've got some fish sticky oil here. I'm going to put a bit more in. It's got some dryer in it. And it's been in there for about a week now. I've just diluted it with some nice linseed, ordinary linseed. Nothing expensive here, apart from the dryer. Right, so let's get a nice mix of... Going to leave some... some floods. I love doing these. They're great fun to do. So we'll have a sort of flood coming down here. Put some red in the sky, a bit of red and Payne's grey. Had a bizarre thing on Facebook today. Our local Beddington Lane is always pestered with roadworks, never ending. We've got an Asda down there, which is our local shop. We pick up a friend and take there. Last 5 o'clock this morning, there was a hit and run, and apparently, and I don't know if this is true yet, it's in the local rag, that the driver put the body in the boot of the car and drove off, or dragged the body onto the pavement, we don't know, but it's a very serious incident, that's for sure. Okay, I'm going to wipe out some of this, just stain it with a bit of colour. Now I want to have a bit of shape on that landscape. South Wales has been particularly badly hit with the storms. Oh, that's a fall off. All right, let's put in some. So I'll put in some trees on the distance there. Cheap old brushes. The idea not to keep both. Oh, we could just come up here a bit with one of these. Okay, let's clean the brush. Alright, that's it. I don't want to make this the same as I've done before, but I want this sort of a river coming. Or a flood kind of there, but for floodplains you need it's like that. Got a bit higher with the you don't want the horizon right in the middle like that. So we'll just take it above, up a bit. Right, let's shine that up a bit. Okay, well that'll do, let's put a bit of red in there. Okay, let's get in some so I was silent. A bit of paint's grey in that foreground, and a bit of red. Could do a good stipple with this method. Let's get a taller tree. An idea. Bit of a hedge. Try to get some there's plenty of oil on there, so we don't have to put too much on the brush. Okay, let's start to model where the water's, where we think the water's going to go. Plenty of scope for putting reflections in. Not quite. see if we can enliven. Right, let's do a bit of sky. Getting a bit lost in that reflection there. So let's go somewhere else. Let's go a bit red. Bit of blue, bit of red. Trying to get a nice light horizon without using pure white. A big bit of ochre, yellow ochre. Normally I've gone on a bike ride this morning, but like last week, it's too cold wind. It's not that cold temperature, but it's the wind and the mud that's going to be about on our ride along the Wandle. Let's have a bit of background. More blue. Alright, let's go back to this here. Mark some of it out. I want to get some counter change in there. That means dark against light. might put some trees in front of that. Use the cotton bud, I think. Forgot to drink my tea. Yeah, we're all cold tea, awful. We've got some dark there, so let's put that in. I'm trying to get away with my brush here. 2-inch cheap bristle. The sky, I haven't finished with the sky yet. Right, let's lift out a bit of grass here. Try to drag some of that down. Let's give it a thump with that. See if we can just put a bit more texture in. We've taken stuff out, we haven't put anything in. Really, what we've done is put some colour in. I think I've gone wrong with that colour there. So let's go back to that green. Try to just cover up some mistakes. Ah, right, I was going to do something on there, wasn't I? So I put a bit of Payne's grey, a bit of blue. bit better. Just, I didn't really want to go up that high. So you could take out, put back, just have fun with it. Oh, that's not very good. Okay, that's not quite the right kind. Too much pain's growing that. But I'm not going to change it. Well, that's not too bad. No doubt you'll let me know what you think. I hope so. I'll put it in the frame. So bear with me. They all look best with a frame. But cut your boards according to the frame available. Then you won't have to get the picture down. Right, that's just... Well, I'm not going to make any alterations with the camera, but I'm just... Yeah, that'll do. If I've got any... trying to match. Trying to get that reflection. Alright, well, I'll let that go. Hope you like it, folks. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.